Hey friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. Today we are going to discuss a very important index, that is World Giving Index. So let's begin this video, but before that, if you are coming here for the first time, then do not forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell notification. And this is the Telegram group which you can join from the link given in description below. And here you can enjoy the free quizzes that we provide. Also, you can get the latest updates about the exams that are provided on this Telegram channel. So guys, this is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022. Here you will get PDFs, videos and mocks along with the mock interviews. So you will be prepared for your final interviews as well. And this is the booklet that you will get if you enroll in this course. Here we have 30% discount on this course, which you can use by RBI 30 coupon code. And this is the number which you can dial if you have any query related to the examination. So here is our first question. What is India's rank in the World Giving Index 2021? First of all, this index is released by Charities Aid Foundation. So Charities Aid Foundation releasing the Giving Index that clearly indicates the purpose of this index, that is to identify or to rank the countries on the basis of charities done by its citizens. So here, what is the rank of India? The rank of India is 14. That is option C is the right answer. And this rank is out of 114 countries. So total 114 countries were assessed. Which country is at the top? It is Indonesia. So the citizens here give the highest amount of charity in comparison to the other countries assessed in this report. And which country is at the bottom? It is the land of rising sun, that is Japan. So it gives the least amount of charity. So that is all about this index. That is the most that you needed to know about this index. Apart from this fact that India is the top 10 countries. India is among the top 10 countries which have showed the maximum improvement. So earlier India used to be in the global ranks of 82. And this is the tremendous increase in its ranking that India has achieved to be at 14th rank. So that is all. Now let's discuss the second question. Who has won Pulitzer Prize 2021 in fiction for The Night Watchman? So the other way around, this question can be asked from you is that who is the author of The Night Watchman? So the answer would be the same in both the questions. That is option A, Louis Etheridge. So he is the author of this Night Watchman. The book has got the Pulitzer Prize 2021 in the category of fiction. And this is the table. This is the list of winners. So first of all, the very first thing that you should remember is that Pulitzer Prize is given in journalism, books, drama and music field. So this is another static question coming from this current news. Now remember that the categories mentioned here are not all, because there were many categories provided for in the Pulitzer Awards, but I have chosen the most important categories here only. So the first category is public service, won by New York Times. The second category is international reporting, won by Megha Rajgopalan for exposing the China's detention camps. The third category is local reporting, won by Kathleen McGurry and Neil Bailey. Remember, the categories in the journalism that I have picked are important because these have been won by Indian origin journalists Megha Rajgopalan and Neil Bailey. That is why these awards are important. Next comes the books, drama and music. So in fiction, we have discussed it is Night Watchman by Louis Etheridge. In drama, it is the Hot Winking by Katori Hall. In poetry, the Postcolonial Love Poem by Natalie Diaz. And in music, Stride by Tanya Leon. So these are the winners that you have to remember from this year's Pulitzer Prize. Next question is, which IIT has developed Jeevan Vayu, India's first CPAP device that functions even without electricity? First of all, let me tell you what the CPAP device is. This device is used for providing oxygen to the patients who are unable to inhale proper oxygen themselves. So that is the simple explanation for this CPAP device that you can remember for understanding this news. Now, IIT Roper is the right answer that has developed this Jeevan Vayu CPAP device. And remember, it is India's first CPAP device that can function even without electricity. Now guys, you must have heard about this Swasth Vayu ventilator. So these Swasth Vayu ventilators have been developed by a CSIR lab, and that lab developed these ventilators to fill in for the shortage of oxygen ventilators in the year 2020. Your task is to tell me that which lab developed this Swasth Vayu ventilator. So if you are covering up with the current affairs, well, then you would know that recently Ministry of Health and Family Welfare's committee has also recommended this Swasth Vayu ventilator. That means that it can be used on the patients who are facing severe oxygen problem. So that is why it was very much in the news, and now it is your task to find out the name of the lab that has developed this Swasth Vayu ventilator. Moving on to the next question. Which state has launched RevUp Accelerator program to empower AI startups? So we have Telangana, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat and Uttar Pradesh in the options. Out of these, the right answer is Telangana. Now this RevUp Accelerator program has been launched under Telangana AI Mission, PM, Telangana AI Mission. Guys, I hope that you know that the 2020 year was declared as the year of AI by the state of Telangana. So by keeping in mind that year only, that celebration or that mission only, this Telangana AI mission has been launched, and under this mission, this RevUp Accelerator program has been launched. Now, what is the purpose of launching this program? Clearly, accelerator programs are for these startups, to boost these startups by providing them funding, by providing them training and the right guidance for operating in the market. So clearly, this RevUp Accelerator program is for these startups, and startups particularly functioning in the field of AI, artificial intelligence. Now, there is another level of eligibility required for these startups to be eligible under this RevUp Accelerator program, and that eligibility is that they should be based in the city of Hyderabad. So remember, the startups which are in the city of Hyderabad are only eligible for this RevUp Accelerator program. So I hope that this much is information is important and this much is relevant for your examination. Now, you would also know about the V-Hub. So this is basically the incubator program. You must have heard about this V-Hub. It has been in the news for quite a long period of time. Now this V-Hub is the incubator program, and precisely it is India's first state-led incubator program for promoting women entrepreneurship. Now you would be thinking why I am telling you this, because my question is springing up from this V-Hub initiative only. So this V-Hub initiative has in the recent past partnered with the iHub incubator system. You have to tell me that in which state is this iHub located, or which state does this iHub incubation program belong to. This is your task. Tell me in the comment section below. Which of the following foundations received funding from NABARD in the Gramya Vikas Nidhi for the development of off-farm sector activities through skill training? Reliance Foundation, Tata Trust, HCL Grant, Ambuja Cement Foundation, Mahindra Rice Foundation are in the options, out of which Ambuja is the right answer. Now, Ambuja and NABARD have been implementing the skill training program in rural areas where they train the people who are not engaged in the agricultural activity. So off-farm sector activities refers to the activities that are apart from the agriculture activities. So the people in the rural areas who are not engaged in the agriculture activities are trained, are skill trained by Ambuja Cement Foundation. And for that skill training only, NABARD provides the financial assistance, and that financial assistance is provided under the Gramya Vikas Nidhi. So basically, Gramya Vikas Nidhi is nothing but the fund, the name of the fund, which received the financial assistance from NABARD for this skill training program. So that is all that you need to remember from this question. Your task is to tell me the chairman of NABARD at present. That is all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching this video.